来到这 BMP 已经一年多的时间了哈，特别开心能够跟大家一起相处，一起来认识我们的神，并且呢，我看到我们的教会也在茁壮的成长哈，人数也在不断的增加。
It has been a year since I came to BMP for the very first time, and I'm glad that the church is growing.
好，这个是我就是。大家可能好久没看人拿纸质版的圣经了哈，这个我开始可能想说一点点我个人的体会，就是有时间有机会的话，我们除了用手机或者平板去看圣经的时候，尽量能够抽时间去看看纸质版的圣经，因为它有些地方不一样，它是替代不了的。因为最起码有一件事儿，就是每段经文在经文当中，在圣经当中的位置。你在平板电脑在手机里是没有感觉的哈，这个我觉得很重要。
So here is the physical Bible, which I believe that many people haven't been seeing for a while. But I urge everybody here that when the time allows for it, when opportunity allows for it, to use the physical Bible, it's because there's something irreplaceable inside the physical copy. It's that where you can see the position of each and every single book and verses that is inside the physical book. This is not shown online, which includes devices and also phones that we normally use every day. So it is just an encouragement for all of you.
好，那我们开始今天的分享。我的题目是神工智能。
So let us start the topic for today. My topic is God made intelligence.
这个题目在昨天，不好意思，就是昨天发的有点晚，昨天才发给这个制作幻灯的姐妹们。那因为我的英文不好，所以我只发了一个中文，这个翻译起来有点困难。
Okay, so actually this topic, I've just sent yesterday because I find it challenging to translate it in a way that it would be succinct in the English language.
所以最开始我在教会的 WhatsApp group 那个 group 里面看到那个题目，就翻译的有点跟我讲的意思不一样，它翻译成了。神的智能哈，实际上不是神的智能，而是我们要说的是神所造的智能哈。
So at the start, actually, the English was actually is called God's intelligence, but that is not the actual meaning that I want to bring out. So it is changed to God made intelligence.
好，它对应的就是我们这两年最最火爆的哈，就是人工智能。哪一个？最近一年，在全世界，我觉得除了两场战争之外，人类世界发生最最重要的事情，就是人工智能进入到我们生活当中。这个是我觉得是在蒸汽机、计算机、互联网之后，人类的科技的最大的一次革命哈。
So there are many things that change the world, including the two world wars. Other than these two.There's also one major thing, which is AI, artificial intelligence. This has been a significant impact to us ever since the inception of the Industrial Revolution, the Internet, and so much more.
因为我本身是医生，同时也做一些医疗器械的生意，所以我在接触这个行业的时候，在今年参加一些学术会议，发现一个特别特别大的变化。
So since I am also a doctor, I will also be taking care of matters that is regarding to pharmaceutical devices and in the industry. So one way or another, I will be interacting with these technologies. And in one of the seminars that I have attended, I have found something great and profound.
变化就是，人工智能已经进入到医学的每一个领域里面，成为了在各个医学会议上最最重要的那个主角。
So when it comes to technology, it has become the primary use. It has become the primary source of information, and also in the medical doctor's workflow.
我现在看到很多医生做手术已经不是像原来拿着手术刀在做手术了，很多很多都是用机器人在做。通过 AI 的辅助在做手术，非常非常多。
So I have seen majority of the doctors no longer use their own hands to perform surgery. However, it is now all using machines assisted by AI.
我第一次在十几年前接触达芬奇机器人，这个是世界上最最好的一个外科机器人啊，这是在十几年前进入到医院开始商业使用的。我最开始接触它的时候，我被它震惊了。就是我们人根本不可能去完成的动作，在它来说太 easy 了，非常非常的 easy。
So I have fiddled myself with one of the technology that has been very prominent in the industry 10 years ago. And the first time I used it, I was shocked because the things that is utterly impossible for humans to do, it is very easy for the machine.
我们的手顶多转180度，可是那个机器人的手可以不停地在一个方向转，再回来转，左转右转。我们的手根本不可能达到这样的，再优秀的外科医生也不可能。
Take for example, the things that is impossible for us humans is to do is to turn our wrist 180. At most, we can only turn 180. But for the machine, it can turn endlessly. It can change here, change there, it changes the angles everywhere. Where for us as doctors, it is impossible for us to do.
那么 AI 也一样。在十几年前，我有大家有喜欢下棋的人吗？不管是什么棋，任何棋，我相信可能有些人很感兴趣啊，喜欢下国际象棋，喜欢下围棋。
Quick question here: Does anybody here likes to play chess? Any kind of chess? Okay, okay. There's a lot of people likes to play chess. Okay, okay. Yeah, so many people likes to play chess.
十年前就人类最厉害的国际象棋选手和围棋选手。都已经败在了人工智能的手下。
So 10 years ago, the top players on many chess in certain occasions has been completely defeated by AI.
所以我们人工智能和计算机的发展是一个飞速的发展，而且会对我们的未来的生活有巨大的影响。
So as you can see, this term, artificial intelligence, it is growing very quickly over the years, and eventually it's going to be a major part in our life, just as how smartphones and internets are.
我今天谈到 AI, 其实是想带着大家做一些思考，用 AI 作为一个比喻，作为一个例子。
So the reason why I want to use AI as a topic, because I want to use it as a point for all of us to ponder.
首先我们是不是大家都认可 AI 是被创造出来的机器人是被创造出来的有没有人觉得它是自己进化来的没有
So does anybody think that AI created itself? There must be a creator, right?
它确实有进化的现象它从计算机的技术一代一代更新到今天它是有在进化的过程但是它不是自己被创造，不是自己创造的自己，也不是自己进化来的。
So AI is an evolved, it is actually started by an evolution of technology. It started from calculators to phone to computers, supercomputers, then eventually to AI. However, it did not create itself or evolved itself for any of that matter.
所以我们都知道AI 的创造者是我们人类，是被我们人类所创造出来的。
So as we all know, actually AI is created by us humans.
创造它的目的是什么呢？创造它的目的是做我们人类的帮助者，辅助我们去工作，辅助我们去更好的生活，提高我们的工作效率。
So what is the purpose of us creating AI? It's very simple. It is to help us in maybe on some drudgery, on the tiny things that we might not have time to do, and it helps us to increase our work productivity.
那么我们跟 AI 的关系是很清晰。AI 是我们创造出来的工具，它是一个工具。
So our relationship with AI is very close, and the relationship we have with AI is that we are the master, it is a tool.
好，那是人类是如何一步一步的发明创造出这么厉害的东西呢？
But a question that we must ask is, How are we as humans able to develop such a thing that is as advanced as AI?
这里面我觉得最重要的就是人类掌握了科学的方法之后，我们对这个世界的认知越来越清晰，我们掌握的知识越来越多，对外界的知识越来越多，同时对我们自己的头脑的运转、思维的逻辑关系、整个的思维方式认识越来越清晰。
So the reason for that, that why AI has become so such a well-developed product as this, it is because ever since we grasped about science, we start to know about the world more, and most importantly, we start to know about our own self, more particularly, how we as humans think.
所以这个 AI 也好，计算机机器人也好，是其实是个仿生学的高级仿生学，它仿的是我们人类自己。
So actually, AI, what it is purely imitation. What does it imitate? It is our own human brain.
那被仿出来的 AI 都那么厉害，是被造出来的。那我们的思维是从哪里来了？我们的智能是从哪里来的呢？
Now, if AI is being developed and is an imitation of our own human brain, then what about our very own original brain?
我们对世界的了解，我们所掌握的这些知识，那都是我们的发现，并不是我们的发明和创造。这个世界不是我们造的，这些规律、这些知识不是我们造出来的，只是我们发现的东西。
So in these things that we did not actually created it on our own, it is through how we are able to, as we live longer in this world, we discover more things, and we are able to develop them as so.
所以我们只是发现者，我们并不是这个世界和自己的创造者。
So,The reason why we are so well developed is because we are able to discover more things, not because that we ourselves are part of the Creator.
所以我们是从神而来，是从上帝的创造而来。
And the one main point is that we are the creation of God. In His image, He created us.
好，那我们知道人创造 AI 的大概的过程。那上帝造我们是怎么造的呢？我们看看圣经里面的记载哈。
So we know that AI is created in the image of humans, but we are created in the image of God. So let us check a bit、
就是、
of the verses.、
我们看看神工智能是如何产生的哈，记爱是如何产生的。
So let us just briefly go through how was God made intelligence made.
我们看创世纪当中记载的上帝创造人的过程，大概分了两段的经文哈。我们先看第一段的经文，我们用起应的方式，我来读一节，大家读一节，中文的哈。神说：“我们要照着我们的形象，按着我们的样式造人，使他们管理海里的鱼、空中的鸟、地上的牲畜和全地。”并地上所爬的一切昆虫。神就赐福给他们，又对他们说，要生养众多，遍满地面，治理着地，也要管理海里的鱼、空中的鸟和地上各样行动的活物。至于地上的走兽和空中的飞鸟，并各样爬在地上有生命的物，我将青草赐给他们做食物。事就这样成了。Amen.
Amen. So, how do we know that we are created in the image of God? The reference point is on the very first chapter, which is from Genesis 1 to 30. So it says here,And God said, Let us make man in our image, like us, and let him have rule over fish of the sea and over birds of the air, and over the cattle and over all the earth, and over every living thing which goes flat on the earth. And God made man in his image. In the image of God, he made him. Male and female, he made them. And God gave them his blessing and said to them, be fertile and have increase and make the earth full and be masters of it. Be rulers over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the air and over every living thing moving on the earth. And God said, see, I have given you every plant producing seed on the face of all the earth and every tree which has fruit producing seed. They will be your food. And to every beast of the earth and to every bird of the air and every living thing moving on the face of the earth, I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. Amen.
好，我们同样思考一下这个我们被造的时候跟神的关系哈。创造者是神，那么神创造我啊，神创造我们的目的是什么呢？在这段经文里我们看到非常清楚，神造我们是要完成他给我们的工作啊，是要去管理他所造的这个世界。
So another thing that we need to ponder is what is the purpose that we as humans were created by God for? So in here, in the first few verses in Genesis chapter 1, it is mentioned very clearly, is that we are here to do his work.
就像 AI 技术，就像计算机技术，从最开始的一代一代的升级到今天，它有一个过程一样。那我们人类被造出来的时候，是不是就有这个能力直接就去管理这个世界了呢？还没有啊。
So when it comes to AI, we do know that it didn't start off as AI immediately. It started off being with primitive devices, then it slowly evolves. But what about for us? Do we have the ability right away?
所以整本圣经里面要告诉我们的事情，就是神要如何建立我们成为一个能够符合神的心意，按照他的心意去管理这个世界的人。
So, as you can see, the whole point of the Bible is to mention is the overall process of how we as humans continue to develop and to change so that we can become God's own people to be able to rule over the earth.
所以我们是在不断被神更新升级换代的一个过程。
By the Holy Spirit and by the Father and the Son himself, we are continually changed and also to shape to become eventually God's holy people.
所以我们可以跟我们旁边的人说哈，愿上帝在今天的敬拜当中更新我们。愿上帝在今天的敬拜当中更新我们。
So in this congregation, we are changed.Basically, you don't need to say. So, but we can bravely say to one another that in this holy congregation, we as brothers and sisters of Christ are changed people.
那么我们跟这个创造者之间的关系是什么呢？我们在经文当中很清晰地看到，首先神是按照神的形象造我们的。这意味着什么？这是意味着我们是神儿女的形象，我们是神儿女的身份。
So as we can see here, let us continue with our relationship with the Lord. And what is it? It is mentioned in here that we were made in His image, and male and female He made them. So what does it actually mean? It means that we are the children of God, because just like how we were made in our parents' image, we are made in our father's God's image.
我前两天在新加坡旅行的时候，去见我的一个多年未见的朋友，他带着他的孩子出现在我面前的时候，当时我和我太太都笑起来了。两个人长得一模一样，一个九岁的孩子跟一个五十岁的一个男人，长得一模一样。
So there's a little story that I want to share that.2 days ago, I actually went to Singapore to meet a long-lost friend. And when I meet him and also his son, me and my wife were shocked and we also laughed out loud. Why? It is because both of them, one is age 9, another one is age 50, they look entirely the same.
所以孩子就是像父母啊，孩子的身上一定是有父母的形象。
So what does this imply? Is that children...have the parents' image.
所以我们每一个人要清楚，要知道，我们都是神的儿女。
So it is clear that we need to know that we are actually God's children.
这个跟 AI 和我们的关系可完全不一样。AI 是工具，我们是儿女。
So the difference in here between AI and also about God is this, is that our relationship with AI is a tool. But God's relationship with us, we are his children.
那除了我们是儿女的身份之外，我们在经文当中还很清晰地看到上帝创造我们是要做他的管家和仆人，去替他按照他的心意去管理这个世界，所以我们的关系是君臣或者说是主人和仆人的关系。
So we are not just children of God, but we are also his servants, that we are produced and also be made here in this world to do his work as stewards of Christ. So it is not just that we have our relationship, with God, it is not as a child of God, but to also a servant of God.
好，那我们看看神是如何造我们的呢？刚才是神造我们的身份和目的，那么以及关系，那我们再看看神是怎么造的我们。在圣经当中，这个经文记载也非常清楚，在创世纪二章第七节里面，我们一起来念。耶和华神用地上的尘土造人，将生气吹在他鼻孔里，他就成了有灵的活人，名叫亚当。
So we have known who we are, and we have known why we are, but let us now think how we are, how are we made here in this world. In Genesis chapter 2 verse 7 it says, And the Lord God made man from the dust of the earth,breathing into him the breath of life, and man became a living soul, Adam.
好，这还没有结束，这是只是一半的工作，创造了男人，还有女人呢。
So one thing to take note here is that the creation, the work of creation is not yet done. We have just created man.
好，我们还是起应的方式来读一下这段经文。耶和华神将那人安置在伊甸园，使他修理看守。树上的果子你可以随意吃，只是分别善恶树上的果子你不可吃，因为你吃的日子必定死。耶和华神说，那人独居不好，我要为他造一个配偶帮助他。耶和华神用土所造成的野地各样走兽和空中各样飞鸟都带到那人面前，看他叫什么，那人怎样叫各样的活物，那就是他的名字。耶和华神使他沉睡，他就睡了，于是取下他的一条肋骨，又把肉合起来。那人说，这是我骨中的骨，肉中的肉，可以称她为女人，因为她是从男人身上取出来的。
So this next one is the process of how the female has been created. In Genesis chapter 2 verse 15 all the way to 24, it is mentionedAnd the Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to do work in it and take care of it. And the Lord God gave the man orders, saying, You may freely take the fruit of every tree of the garden, but the fruit of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you may not take, for on the day when you take of it, death will certainly come to you. And the Lord God said, It is not good for the man to be by himself.I will make one like himself as a helper to him. And from the earth, the Lord God made every beast of the field and every bird of the air and took them to the man to see what names he would give them. And whatever name he gave to any living thing, that was its name. And the man gave names to all cattle and to the birds of the air and to every beast of the field. But Adam had no one like himself as a helper.And the Lord God sent a deep sleep on the man. and took one of the bones from his side while he was sleeping, joining up the flesh again in its place. And the bone which the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman, and took her to the man. And the man said, "This is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. Let her name be woman, because she was taken out of man. For this cause will a man go away from his father and his mother, and be joined to his wife, and they will be one flesh." Amen.
好，我们从创造的过程当中，我们看到，人不仅仅是有肉体，人的肉体是神用泥土做成。那么人除了肉体之外，还有神的灵在我们的里面。神，区别于其他的所有的被造物，无论是树啊、植物啊，还是动物，还是石头，海水，没有一个神是有神的灵的。唯有我们人类是带着神的灵的。
In Genesis chapter 2, we can see that we as humans are not merely made of flesh and blood, but we are also created from the dust of the earth, and more importantly, God's breath, which contains His Spirit. Out of all the beasts of the earth, we have His Spirit.
那我们知道人工智能最重要的它是要有一个自主学习的过程。
So, when it comes to humans, when they themselves have been created, us, we have been created, we need to slowly develop and evolve our knowledge of the world here.
它只有积累到一定足够的数据量、知识量之后，它才可以开始智能性的思考、逻辑推理。
So just like AI, for we as humans, we need to continue to develop our knowledge and our wisdom so that we are able to creatively make decisions and to also put things in a logical and in a faithful manner.
那么人是不是一被造出来的时候就已经是一个完善的 GI 了呢？就已经完善的有这个 GI 了吗？
So if we...So if AI needs time to develop into who they are now, who it is now, then what about us? We also need to slowly develop that knowledge and wisdom and data as well.
所以我们知道上帝造我们也是有一个GI的成长的一个过程。
So just like AI, we also have a time that where we need to slowly develop and accumulate our intelligence.
我们在今天的这段经文里看到了一个非常非常重要的东西哈，这儿就是分别善恶树。哇，在神造我们的时候，特意还造了一棵分别善恶的树。
So there, in here, in Genesis chapter 2, there is one major thing.As you can see in Genesis chapter 2, verse 17, it says, "Of the fruit of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you may not take." So, in the Garden of Eden, this fruit is planted right in the center.
在我没有信主之前，我会觉得这个上帝太奇怪了。他为什么造了人，又造个分别善恶树，然后让人去堕落犯罪，然后去怎么样？被他惩罚，这个上帝，这个太不可思议，不可理解了哈。
So before I believe in the Lord, when I first look at this verse, the first thing that come into my mind is, this God is a very strange God. Why would he make a place that where his people can stumble? Why does he put it there? Couldn't he just not make it at all?
你直接创造出来这个人就只听你的话不就得了吗？对吗？
So, if you are the Lord and you can do anything, why don't you just create humans that fully obey you and then everything will be fine?
但是今天我才真正的认识到上帝的美好的心意和计划。
But today, I begin to realize the good plan of God.
他不是要创造唯命是从的跟随他的人。 唯命是从，他说什么就做什么的人。
So he does not want people to be merely tools that follow him everything on his own whim and his command.
他需要的是有自己的思想，有自己的选择，心甘情愿地去跟随他的人。
He wants people that has their own knowledge, their own agency, their own ability to choose and think, and they themselves voluntarily want to submit to him.
所以神造这棵分别善恶树，就是一个非常非常重要的，让我们能有选择的机会的一个创造。
So the reason why this tree of the fruit of good and evil is there in the first place, it is given we as humans to choose.
那么他给了我们这个分别善恶树，给了我们犯错误的机会。那他有没有再给我们挽回的机会呢？
So he has also given us good choices, also bad choices, and he has given us chances to make mistakes. But do we have chances to be able to turn back?
所以他赐下了耶稣基督给我们。我们因为分别善恶树的原因，我们离弃了神，我们选择了我们做自己的主人，我自己想的是最正确的，我已经看到了最好的，而离弃了上帝的那个话语，你不要吃分别善恶树的果子。
So this is precisely the reason why Jesus Christ has died for us for our sins, because in the very beginningWhen we were told to not eat the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil, we decide to make that choice. I want to make choices for myself. I want to have the ability to choose my own destiny. And that is why Christ is here for our sins.
那当我们人类离弃神之后，就被罪所辖制，罪的工价就是死。
And when we choose our own way,We were led and blinded by sin. For the wages of sin is death.
所以我们看到，从亚当夏娃犯罪之后，第一件发生的重要的事情就是他们两个人的亲生的两个儿子互相残杀，该隐杀了亚伯。
So the very first thing, the first tragic thing that happened after the fall, it was Cain and Abel, both sons.Of Adam and Eve killed each other.
直到今天，我们看到战争没有一个时刻在地球上停止过。
So in here, we all know that even as we live here peacefully right here, right now, there is still war and it still didn't end.
在中东最相似的两个民族在互相的残杀。
So as we can see in current times, the war that we know, everybody knows.
他们原本是兄弟，但是现在是敌人。
Originally, they were brothers, but now they were enemies.
这不是因为神栽了分别善恶树的果子，而是因为他们选择了离弃神。
This is not because of the knowledge of the fruit of good and evil, but because they chose to be away and apart from the Lord.
所以人类离弃神之后，在罪恶的这个管制之下，走向堕落，走向死亡。
So for the wages of sin is death, why is it so? Because every time that we remain disconnected from the Lord and we decide to be in the grasp of sin, we become depraved and therefore leads to death.
那么AI 我们知道它有一个学习的不断的过程，它的核心是运算，大数据的这个积攒学习和运算速度的增快，这个是 AI 技术的核心。
So in AI it continues to grow by giving it a lot of data for it to work with, and then it makes countless mistakes, errors, calculationsand reformations to the point that it can become the AI that it is today.
我最开始试那个 ChatGPT 的时候发现了一个特别有趣的现象，就是 我用简体中文和英文还有繁体中文三种不同的语言搜一个问题的时候，他的回答是不一样的，甚至是完全相反的。
So at the very first time when I tried ChatGPT, I decided to ask it a question, but I mentioned it in English, simplified Chinese, and also traditional Chinese. But what shocked me is that it is not just the answer is different, but it is opposite of one another.
既爱也一样，我们人学习的什么，相信的什么，决定了我们的结果。
So, when it comes to GI, God-made intelligence, it is the same way. We need time to process, to calculate, and eventually to make logical decisions.
如果我们认为金钱是我们生命最大的价值，我们就成了被金钱所造的人。
What we believe becomes our destiny. For example, if we allow money to be our master, then eventually our destiny would be we will continually be surrounded by money and as a slave of money.
有些人崇拜的是人所造出来的偶像，无论是各种各样的偶像的崇拜，都是人所造出来的偶像，反而成了某些人自己的心中的偶像。
There are also people as well worship idols that are created by man. And for them, they become slaves to that too.
还有人可能甚至把自己的孩子做成了生命最重要的那个部分。
And it is also not uncommon to see that children become the idol inside parents' heart.
无论是金钱，无论是孩子，无论是我们的家庭，都非常非常的重要。
No matter if it's money, no matter if it's your child, no matter it's your family or your parents, all these things are very important.
但那都不是最重要的。
However, it is not the most important.
最最重要的是我们和创造我们的主的关系。
But the most important thing.Is our relationship with our Creator, the Lord Himself?
We see that man after the fall is to self-destruction. We
can see what happened, the terrible effect after we have separated from the Lord. The rest was history.
虽然我们掌握了各种各样的科学的先进的技术和工具。
Even though we are able to attain mastery in different areas, levels, expertise, tactics, and also in the workplace.
这些技术在提高我们生活生产的效率的同时，它也提高了杀人的速度，提高了我们这个社会、这个世界走向灭亡的效率。
As much as these things improve our productivity and it improves our power, it also increases the power of harming, malice, and also includes murder as well.
那么人类的希望到底在哪里？人的救赎到底在哪里？这就是上帝他在祭爱的过程当中最最重要的核心那部分，就是他亲自的来到我们当中，把他自己做成一个程序，放在我们里面。
So when there's so many things that we have to worry about, especially when these problems are going to grow larger and larger, who can we have hope? Who can we trust? We can trust that Jesus Christ, the Son of the Lord, has died for our own sins, and we are freed.
这就是主耶稣道成肉身来到我们当中，走到十字架上为我们付出他生命的代价，流出他的宝血。死后三天从坟墓当中复活的意义所在。
So the word was God, the word was made flesh. He went through 30 years overgoing his service. He prayed, he made miracles, he died on the cross, he resurrected 3 days after and to continue to provide his wisdom and his blood to us.
我们看约翰福音十九章三十节记载的耶稣在十字架上所说的最后一句话，我们一起来念。耶稣尝了那醋，就说成了，便低下头将灵魂交付给神。
So it is written in here, in John chapter 19, verse 30. So when Jesus has taken the wine, he said, all is done. And with his head bent, he gave up his spirit.
成了是什么意思？是什么成了？是神在耶稣基督身上的救赎的工作成了。
So what does it mean by all is done? What is all? It means all of the work that is needed to provide the salvation for us through Jesus Christ.
他用他的生命成就了上帝的救赎的计划。
Through the cross, he fulfilled the plan of the Lord.
但是我们要注意一点，耶稣的工作只是一部分，三分之一，这个事儿没结束呢，他的成了，耶稣做的这部分工作成了，结束了，完成了，后面还有。
However, this is just one third of the overall of the whole thing. God has done his part, which is to save us through Jesus Christ. But there is still two more parts that we need to be concerned.
一部分是天父的工作，天父使他在死后三天复活，从坟墓当中复活。
First is the work of the Father. He still needs to resurrect the Son 3 days after.
如果没有这个复活，耶稣在十字架上结束他的工作，那只是一个英雄而已。
So, in here, it is not enough for Christ Jesus just to die for our sins. That is just half of the plan.
神要告诉我们的是，耶稣不是一个，不仅仅是个英雄，耶稣是我们的救赎者，他是神的儿子，他是神的一部分啊。
So it is not just the death of Jesus Christ. It is not an end of itself. However, it is still the work of the Father that he is also a son of God, die for our sins.
所以没有复活，我们的救恩是成就不了的。
So without the work of the Father to resurrect Jesus Christ, the work would be meaningless.
那么我们常常说去传福音，大家传的福音的核心是什么呢？
So every time we were told to go and make disciples of all nations, but what is the core of our gospel?
福音的核心最最简单的一句话就是耶稣复活了。
The core message, it is not that Christ died for our sins, but Christ has been resurrected.
这是人类历史上最最重要的一件事情。
This in the worldIs the most profound event.
那么还有三分之一的工作是什么呢？是耶稣升天之后所赐下的圣灵的工作。
Now, what about the final part of God's work and plan? It is that God has given us the Holy Spirit.
耶稣升天之后，上帝通过圣灵与我们人类有新的连接。
After Jesus has left and ascended to heaven,He gave us the Holy Spirit to be with us as our helper.
这就是看到上帝给我们的心中建立这个祭爱的过程，从被造到我们离弃神堕落，到上帝的救赎的工作完成之后，是我们的工作。
So as you can see here, this just like how AI has a process, we as humans, GIAlso has a process. So first we were being created, then we were separated because we separate ourselves from the Lord. Then we were saved by the death of His Son and also the resurrection of His Son. And now for repentance, it is our part.
那我们的部分就是你是否愿意接受上帝的这个救恩？你是不是愿意把耶稣的生命放在自己的里面，作为我祭爱运转的那个核心。
So in here, the core message is that are we, our part, are we willing to accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior? And more importantly, what he believes become what we believe. And it would be the very core that happens in our life.
当你接受耶稣基督的生命进入到你的里面，我们就不再是为自己而活， 我们也不仅仅是有自己的能力，而是神与我们同在。
When you accepted the Lord, it is not just that you would live life on your own and you would not depend on your own, but you have a close relationship with the Lord and you would depend on the Lord too.
神与我们同在，必然会改变更新我们的生命。
The Lord is with us every time, every point, and at every moment, and He continues to change and work in us.
他改变我们的生命，希望我们能够像他，像谁的样子呢？像耶稣基督的样子。耶稣基督就是神所赐下的那个榜样，那个样子，就是我们该活成的样子。
God has given us the Holy Spirit to work in us so that eventually we can become a Christ-like person, just as how Jesus Christ has been given us as the perfect model, as the child of God. We were to imitate Him and to be like Him.
如果我们做到这些，我们接受耶稣基督进入我们生命，做我们的主的时候，我们里面有祭爱的时候，我们就是得救的新人。
If we accomplish these things and we allow the Lord to be in our life and let the Holy Spirit to continue to change, that is when GI, the way that we continue to accumulate and to develop, we become a changed man.
耶稣将来还会再来，再次来到我们当中来审判一切的人。
Jesus Christ would come for the second time once again, and we will all be judged.
这个审判的过程就像一个检验过程，这个 AI 是否合乎神所创造的心意。
So, judgment is just like an audit. Whenever an AI is undergoing an audit, he needs to see that whether if this AI is good enough or not.
我们大家想一下，如果我们现在创造出来一个 AI 的机器人，他不听我的指挥了，他不按我所造他的目的去行动，而是他按他自己的意思胡乱去操作的话，大家想想那是多么危险的一件事情。
So let us imagine if ChatGPT were to appear once again. However, whenever you give some information, it would write entirely in a way that you wouldn't want or it goes completely opposite of what you want.It just does its own thing. If that raises a case, will you accept ChatGPT?
在北京有一个区域，现在是有无人驾驶的汽车在里面行走的。
So in Beijing, there is actually a car that is driverless cars. It drives by itself.
它是通过 AI 的技术，在这个区域里面在自由的行走。
How is that possible? It is our very friend again, AI. It helps us to guide the road and it will drive wherever it is commanded to.
如果有一天这些无人驾驶的汽车脱离了我们造它的那个原本的意图。
Now, since the AI is the brain of the car, what happens if the AI goes haywire?
它感染了病毒。
If it has a sickness?
如果它没有了电。
It is a virus or it is out of battery.
或者它的系统的运算的力量不够了。
Or it is slowly become slower.
这个运转的系统就会完全的崩溃。
With all of these things, the AI, the system that it has been created for will completely collapse.
这些无人驾驶的汽车就有可能成为妨碍我们生活的这个产品，甚至有可能威胁我们的生命。
These unmanned cars that were meant to help us and to make lives more convenient, first of all, it would not just become a hindrance at best, but it could endanger our life at worst.
那如果我们想建一座美好的城市，那这些脱离了创造者的被造物，它就不可能给这个城市带来和平和美好，它有可能带来的是灭亡和混乱。
If we were to make a perfect city, which means that everything would be followed, if there's an AI that goes completely on its own, it would disrupt the peace, and there would be no such thing as a perfect city anymore.
所以你如果是这个创造者，你会让感染病毒的汽车进入到你的领域当中吗？
If you are the creator of a city, would you want a car, an unmanned car with an infected virus upon it, to go into your city?
所以耶稣再来审判的过程就是来评判我们是否符合那个创造者的心意。只有符合神的创造者的心意的时候，我们才能够真正的进入到神早就为我们预备的那个新天新地当中。
The final judgment works the same way. All of us will be tested, observed, and also audited to make sure that we fulfill the standard and criteria to enter into God's eternal kingdom.
圣经当中说得很清楚，新天新地不是后来神犯了错误之后一步一步无法返回了又建的新天新地，而是神在创世之初就已经预备好了一个美好的国度。
So in here it is that God has already planned this from the beginning.
他通过整个我们当中祭爱的建立，让我们能够成为一个合格的能够进入到这个新天新地当中的人。
So the creation of the eternal kingdom is not something sudden, but it has been known for us far before it happens, and he has given us the Holy Spirit, the model which is Jesus Christ, so that we can slowly become more and more like him, that we are able to achieve the standard and criteria to enter to his holy kingdom.
在这当中，上帝和我们之间的关系的建立，最最核心的就是信心的建立。
So the core of our relationship with the Lord is faith.
信心它不是个知识，它不是我们能够直接得来的一个东西。信心是有一个建立的过程。
Faith is not knowledge. It's not something that you can get from a book. It needs to be practiced gradually.As you can see in Hebrews chapter 1, verse 11, verse 1.
哇，你翻译的真好。好，我们从摩西的身上，我们就可以看到上帝是如何一步一步的建立摩西的信心。
So in the book of Exodus, when Moses encountered Jesus in the burning bush, it goes through the process of how Moses was changed and continually renewed and improved by the Lord Himself.
鼓励大家有时间可以看一看出埃及记，看看那里面上帝是如何从摩西最开始完全不认识上帝，模模糊糊的状态，到最后对上帝有清晰的认知和有强壮的信心的过程。
So I would like to encourage all of you to read the book of Exodus so that you can observe how Moses started from a man who does not believe or does not know the Lord to the point that where he become one of the greatest figures of our faith.
为什么这么重要呢？因为上帝不仅仅要建立摩西的信心，上帝要建立我们每一个人的信心。
Why do we want to read the story of Moses? It is not just because it's that Moses is built because he's been slowly built by faith. He wants to build everyone's faith.
那信是什么？我们在希伯来书十一章十第一节里面看，信就是所望之事的实底，是未见之事的确据。
As you can see here, faith is succinctly described in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, and the signs that the things not seen are true.
在我们建立信心的过程当中，可能最开始是我们一定要看到，一定要摸到，我一定经历到才能相信。
So we always have the idea of see to believe. If you tell me to believe to see, it's very, very hard to do so.
在耶稣复活之后，他的门徒们是不相信人会复活的。早这些门徒们四散奔逃，已经回去该打鱼的打鱼，该种地的种地。
So before, right during the punishment and also the arrest of Jesus Christ,All the disciples run away like sheep, just run away. Most of them have gone back to their own lifestyle and they never believed actually that there would be a resurrection of a human.
那这个时候复活的耶稣就亲自的显现给他的门徒看。
However, after Jesus Christ has been resurrected 3 days after the crucifixion, he personally went to the disciples.
当经历了复活的耶稣之后，他的门徒们真的建立了信心。
And when they see the resurrected Jesus Christ, their faith is being built.
其中一个门徒大家知道，他听别的门徒说耶稣已经复活了，我见过的时候，他还是不相信。
So there is one particular disciple that heard many people and also his disciples that where Jesus Christ has been resurrected, but he still did not believe.
他说除非让我亲自摸他那个身上的伤痕，我才能相信。
He insisted that unless he touched Jesus Christ, only then he will believe.
那么耶稣就亲自地显现在他的面前，并且让他你来触摸我的伤痕。
So Jesus Christ really showed to him in the flesh and also to let him touch him.
当他的门徒真的将他的手指伸到耶稣被扎的那个伤口当中，亲自地触摸到这个身体是活着的身体的时候，这个门徒真正的相信了。
So when the disciple went and touched the wound that is in Jesus' abdomen, and after he has touched everywhere, and then he truly believed that, yes, Jesus Christ has been resurrected.
而这个相信耶稣基督复活之后的信心，带给门徒们生命完全的转变。
And after they believe in the Lord's resurrection, their life completely changed.
他们从一堆社会最底层的没有文化的渔民税吏变成了影响整个人类的进展的最重要的一群人。
So they came from the lowest of the society to now they become the most profound influence for us in humanity.
我们知道神赐下圣灵与我们同在，但是是否我们能够通过圣灵跟神建立牢固和美好的关系呢？像耶稣的门徒一样靠着圣灵去工作，最最重要的就是信心。
So God has given us the Holy Spirit, but it is still up to us to build that faithful and strong bond with the Lord, and that we are able through him to produce great things, the fruits of the Spirit through him.
你们有这样的信心吗？阿们，阿们，阿们。上帝就是要这样，像建立我们建立 AI 的学习过程当中这个过程一样，建立我们每一个人的信心，建立和他的牢固的关系。
As we slowly start to believe in the Lord and to also build in our faith, we will continue to improve in our wisdom and in our God-made intelligence, just as how artificial intelligence.Is made.
我们每个月都会领圣餐，我们要知道圣餐是耶稣基督在死前设立的，用来纪念他并且与我们每一个人连接的一个仪式。
And everybody knows about the Holy Communion. The Holy Communion is to remember the Lord has sacrificed for us and that we are to continue to build in ourselves his faith.
我们要明白圣餐的含义，在耶稣被卖的那一夜，他拿起饼来祝谢，掰了分给他的门徒。
And before that, he actually separated the bread. He broke the bread down and to give to each and every one of the disciples.
这意味着什么呢？那个饼，他说，这就是我的身体。他亲自将自己的身体撕碎，分给每一个门徒。
And what does the bread imply in the Holy Communion?Jesus said, This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me. He is giving his own body to each of the disciples that is here with him.
掰饼就意味着耶稣在十字架上将自己的身体摆上，做我们每一个人的赎价。
What does it mean by the bread? The bread signifies the body of Christ Jesus broken down for us.
而这个饼我们可以吃掉， 是耶稣基督赐给我们的，是上帝赐给我们的，意味着就是耶稣的身体进入到我们里面，我们愿意接受耶稣基督在我们的里面。
And whenever we eat the bread, it is a sign that we accept the Lord and that we are willing to take the body of Christ into us.
饭后他又拿起葡萄汁来分给大家，说这是我为你们流出的宝血。
And after this, he gave them each a cup of wine, which is, this is my blood for you.
我们靠自己，我们洁净不了，我们的罪洁净不了，我们就像 AI 中了病毒一样， AI 中了病毒，它自己清理不了，它需要工程师，需要人类的帮助灭掉这个病毒。
So similarly, for us,If we are sinful, we cannot drive away our own sin. Just like how when AI is infected by a virus, it cannot drive out its own virus. It needs maybe the manufacturer, it maybe needs someone else, a technician, to help it clear from its virus.
我们的心被病毒感染，我们那个就是罪，偏离了神的罪。
And when we are infected by the virus of sin,We ourselves separate from the command of God.
神就是派下他的独生爱子，用他的血来洁净我们的罪，帮我们消灭这个病毒。
Just like how a technician would be helping the AI to cleanse away from its own virus, God has sent Jesus Christ, has appointed him as our own technician to clear us from our sin.
所以我们靠着耶稣基督在我们里面，我们的里面就得着医治，得着更新，得着升级换代。
And just as how AI has accepted the technician's help, we accept the Lord's help. And because of him, we continue to be renewed, replaced, and also be transformed.
但是我们人有一个特点，这个是罪的另外一个工作，就是特别容易遗忘，特别容易回到自己原来的路上。
However, there is one more important point about us humans that separate us from AI. It's that unlike AI, we easily forget. The moment we are saved, we can easily turn back the another way.
我们在中国的社交媒体上、新闻媒体上会有一个现象，就是不论多么多么严重的一件事，多么多么大家当时群情激昂、特别愤慨的事情，只要这个事情消失两个星期不报道，所有的人会把这件事情遗忘。
In social media, as you can see, that no matter how major something is, no matter how big something is that we have fought for it, don't speak about it for just 2 weeks and everybody will forget it entirely.
所以我们人有这个特点，上帝知道。
We have this point that we easily forget, but the Lord knows.
所以他设立圣餐，所以他设立教会，所以他设立礼拜，让我们每周来到他的面前，被他来更新。
That is why he had the Holy Communion. That is why he had the Holy Spirit. That is why he has the church and the congregation, so that we can continually to be renewed in him.
在圣餐当中与主连接。
And during the Holy Communion, we are connected with the Lord.
在敬拜当中被主所触摸所更新。
And in worship we are touched by the Lord.
我们再一次跟我们旁边的人说，愿主在今天来更新我们。
Let God continue to renew in us. Amen.
那么我们在教会当中有很多很多被神更新的重要的工作，那么包括我们敬拜，在我们的周日的整个的敬拜当中，是我们与主连接，就像一个电脑需要充电。我们在外面工作，我们在外面生活，一周是与魔鬼征战的过程。在与魔鬼征战的过程当中，就像这个 AI 的工具机器人在一直的劳动，它消耗电量，消耗能量。那么在周日的敬拜当中，是我们在这里来充电，来补充上帝给我们的能量，与上帝来连接的过程。
In life, in Monday to Saturday, we work tirelessly, not just that we are able to complete our work, but it is also to fight against the work of the devil. Similarly to how a machine would continually spend its electrical energy on things that where it would become very tired and it would need to recharge. In the same way, Sunday is meant for us to recharge in our faith, in our spiritual energy, so that our cup can be made full again.
还有，除了敬拜，我们有圣经，神赐给我们的圣经就是神的话语。
Other than worship, we have the Bible, and the Bible is the word of God.
耶稣在受试探的时候说，人活着不仅仅是靠着食物，还要靠神的话语。
When Jesus has been tested in Matthew chapter 4, verse 4, he said one thing, man shall not live by bread alone, but would entirely rely on the mouth of God.
神的话语就是我们生命的灵粮。当我们软弱的时候，当我们迷茫的时候，神的话语会给我们力量，也会给我们指引方向。
The word of God is the power of God. And when we are tired, we feel discouraged, burnt out, then we have the word of God to continue to revitalize us.
越读圣经，对圣经越熟悉，我们对我们的神的了解和认识就越清晰。
Why? Because when we continue to read the Bible, our understanding of the Lord continually improves.
就像你想跟一个人建立好的关系，牢固的关系，你原本对他很陌生，那你如何去了解他呢？就是跟他见面聊天，听他说话，向他倾诉，在整个的聊天，在沟通的过程当中，你会逐渐的认识这个人。
Developing a relationship with the Lord is just how you develop a relationship with someone. When you meet someone, you are an acquaintance. Meet three times, you are a friend. Meet even more times, you become the best friend.
那么读经和祷告还有敬拜这三个形式都是我们与神沟通的一个 过程。
So there are many ways that is through worship, that is through prayer, that is through the word of God, that we can continue to meet the God, to meet God each and every single day, so that He can also become our best friend.
啊，还有灵修也是哈。
And of course, devotion is an important part in our life.
那在这样的活动当中，我们被神更新。更新完了 AI 升级或者更新完了要做什么吗在那儿停着在那儿不动不对神我们造 AI 的机器人是要他帮助我们去工作他要有行动
So when we are already fully developed of course we don't stop there just like how AI has been fully developed we still need it to do its work
在更新之后去行动，行动当中又碰到问题，再继续的更新，然后再去行动，再去更新，在行动当中才能发现问题，才能去有目的的更新。
After you have developed enough, then you need to do. But after you do, it is still another problem that you need to solve. Then you need to develop again, and it is an endless cycle repeatedly.
在我们的属灵生命当中，也是有这样的操练的过程。
In our spiritual life, there is also the same process.
我们接受耶稣基督在我们里面，我们就要去行动。我们的行动就不再是我自己的行动，而是我应该按照耶稣的心意去行动了。
And so, similarly in our spiritual life, when we accept Jesus Christ as our Savior, we need to act on it. We need to do. But this time, it is that we do not think of our own accord.We would think, what would Jesus Christ do?
没有人会一下子一瞬间我接受了耶稣基督之后我就成了一个跟耶稣基督完全一样的人不可能
Of course, there isn't a person that immediately becomes like Jesus Christ the moment they accept him as their savior.
我们接受他意味着我们不再自己做自己的生命主。的主人，我们把生命摆上给他， 跟他一起同工。
So in here, when we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, we accept that we are no longer our own master, but our master is of Jesus Christ.
当我生命遇到困难的时候，怎么办呢？找他的帮忙。
When I face any difficulties, or I feel I'm not sure what to do, what do I do? I ask
当我的婚姻遇到了挫折，怎么办呢？找他帮忙。
When my marriage is undergoing troublesome times, who do I do? I ask him.
当我在学习当中有困难的时候，怎么办呢？找他帮忙。
When I'm having trouble in my studies, I ask him.
因为神与我们同在。
Why? Because God is living with us.
那么在神与我们同在的之后，我们要去做服事的工作，在服事当中不断得着神的进一步的更新。
And we would also we are meant to serve as well. So as we serve, we continue to increase in our faith and in also our ability to serve.
所以信仰是我们的根基，它不是我们周日的一个仪式，而是我们生命全部的根基。
It is.So actually, faith is not just a Sunday thing, but it's also a root for all of our days.
神要在我们的每一个领域里面做我们的主人。
So God wants to be the master in all areas of our life.
我们在我们生命当中，无论是工作、婚姻、子女、教育、人际关系、教会的服事，各个方面都建立在耶稣基督的这个磐石之上。
There are many things, such as work, marriage, and family, that we need to continually ask the Lord and seek His wisdom for.
在整个我们的祭爱的系统当中，最最核心的就是神赐给我们那个耶稣基督的生命。
And the reason why we are able to develop, learn, and to evolve in our faith is primarily because we believe in the Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
好，那我们一起来读一段经文哈。Mandy 可以上来了哈。好，我们还是哈起应的方式，我读一节，大家读一节。万物的结局近了，所以你们要谨慎自守，警醒祷告。你们要相互款待，不发怨言。若有讲道的，要按着神的圣言讲；若有服侍人的，要按着神所赐的力量服侍，叫神在凡事上因耶稣基督得荣耀。原来荣耀全能都是他的，直到永永远远。阿门。